Okay. The first demo is, it's a Simply Nice bucket lid. And what I'm going to do is put it on the table and see if I can lift it up. Oh my God. That was incredible. Okay. Let's see if we can make this more interesting. Ah! All right. I wish I had a better handle on this because it's a little bit hard to get a grip, you know? But I can get enough of a grip to hopefully show you that I cannot lift it up. In fact, if I had a better grip, it would probably just lift the whole table. In fact, I know it would. Why does it do that? Let's see if we can understand the forces involved that create a suction cup, even though suction doesn't even exist.
So from now on, let's refer to the ice bucket lid as a suction cup, since we are using it as a suction cup. This video aims to understand the consequences of gas particle behavior, which is why we are using a suction cup, so we will have to take a closer look at 1, the behavior of air particles, and 2, the forces occurring on a surface due to gas particle collisions. Let's use a blue circle to represent the 20% oxygen and 78% nitrogen molecules that make up air particles. All of what we are talking about relies on the fact that air particles are constantly moving at high speed, an average of 513 meters per second at room temperature, which is close to 1200 miles per hour. So the simulation is very slow motion. Since air particles move in random directions, they are constantly colliding with the surface of the suction cup. But what is occurring on the other side of the suction cup? Let's take a cross-section to see that there are air particles constantly colliding on the inside surface as well. To understand the significance of this, let's look at the result of a single air particle hitting a surface. Let's take a closer look. A particle moving at constant speed will quickly slow down, stop, and then speed up and leave the surface. These are accelerations occurring at the point of collision, resulting in a force on the surface. Force is mass times acceleration, and so a force is applied at the point of contact. The particle is pushing on the surface. Let's represent that force with an arrow. Because the mass of the particle is so tiny, the mass of a single oxygen or nitrogen molecule, the force of a single collision is quite small. So, rather than measuring the force of a single particle, we measure the collective force of trillions of surface collisions over a specific area. Would that be a large force? At sea level, that force is 14.7 pounds per square inch, or in SI units, 101,300 pascals, or we could convert that to 1.03 kilograms per square centimeter. And we call that force per unit area pressure. Pressure is force per unit area. But notice on the inside surface, there is that same force, the same amount of collisions per unit area, the same pressure, and so the forces cancel each other. We do not feel them. We only feel the weight of the suction cup, which is quite small. Let's do something interesting. What happens to the particles inside the suction cup when we hit it? They get forced out. And in slow motion to give a better look. The sudden, extremely high-speed rush of particles escaping the smashed suction cup create a chain reaction of fast-moving particles that you hear as a pop when those high-speed particles hit your eardrum. We can now create an illustration that tells us why we cannot lift the suction cup off the table. Using circles and arrows, we can illustrate the force occurring on one side of the suction cup while there are no particles to create an opposing force on the other side. Those particles were pushed out. The arrows represent the force of 14.7 pounds, 6.67 kilograms, per square inch. The suction cup has a radius of 4.5 inches, and so the surface area is pi r squared, pi times 4.5 squared times 14.7 pounds of force for every square inch, resulting in a weight of 935 pounds, or 424 kilograms. The weight pushing down on the surface of the suction cup, resulting from the collective force of thousands of trillions of collisions on the surface by fast-moving air particles. Lifting that suction cup off the table would be the same as lifting 935 pounds or a 424 kilogram mass. This illustrates why suction does not exist. The word suction implies that something is pulling on the suction cup to hold it onto the table. But there is absolutely nothing between the suction cup and the table that could hold it there. Suction is always the result of fast-moving particles constantly hitting a surface and pushing on it without opposition from the other side, or simply those already fast-moving particles going into an empty space that has opened up. This is how vacuum cleaners work, and this is how your lungs work. Think about it. One last word on suction cups. They have to be made out of an elastic material such as rubber or the foam in our example. The long chain polymers that make up these materials can stretch, but that puts a strain on the bonds, putting them at a higher potential energy. The suction cup material wants to go back to its original shape to relieve that strain, decreasing potential energy, and this is where the suction cup shape is crucial. Only the middle will lift up, keeping the perimeter on the surface sealed by both the downward air pressure and the suction cup shape, creating a vacuum. This ensures that the collisions on the outside will not be opposed by added collisions on the inside. The suction cup remains pushed onto the table. This has been a Mad Scientist production.
Okay, see ya.